Hello, I'm Kaiser, and welcome to Moose Reads. Before I get started, I want to say that the opinions that I give here are my own opinions. They are extremely subjective. If I dislike a book, it is not a reflection on the author, and it is not a reflection on people who do like it. Different people have different tastes, and that's okay. Today, I will be reviewing My One and Only Duke by Grace Burroughs. This is the first book in the Rogues to Riches series. It is a Regency romance. The description says, one minute, London banker Quinn Wentworth is facing execution. The next, he's declared the long-lost heir to a dukedom. Quinn has fought his way up from the worst slums, and now he's ready to use every dirty trick he knows to find the enemy who schemed against him. Jane Winston, widowed and pregnant, crosses paths with Quinn while her father is preaching to the prisoners. Believing his days are numbered, Quinn offers her marriage as a way to guarantee her independence and provide for her child. Neither thinks they'll actually have a future together. He's a wealthy gutter rat out for vengeance. She's a minister's daughter who must turn a marriage of desperation into a proper ducal union. Are they doomed from the start or destined for a happily ever after? I'm not giving this book a rating. I'll get into details later, but what it comes down to is that I would generally rate the reading experience as 4, but there's a thing that happens more or less at the climax of the book that pisses me off so much I kind of lean toward a 2. I suppose I could average it out at 3, but that doesn't feel right, so I'm just gonna leave it. As I said, mostly I liked this book. Quinn was a very nice man, aside from the one thing. Jane was fine. I mostly enjoyed the way the plot unfolded. However, there was the thing near the end. I'll explain in detail in the spoiler section, but for non-spoiler people, I'll just say that Quinn does something that is an active betrayal of Jane's trust, and it really irritated me. If it's likely to irritate you, I'd say give this one a pass, except that it's the first in a series and you can't really skip it. Personally, I think the rest of them are worth reconciling with this one. Also, there's a content warning, more or less for the whole series, for child abuse. Quinn's father was a terrible man, and it comes up a lot. That's it for no spoilers. If you don't like spoilers, now is the time to pause or close the video. For everyone else, let's talk details. So, the thing with Quinn. At the start of the book, Quinn is in prison for manslaughter and is soon to be executed. Apparently, manslaughter would usually be commuted to transportation, being sent to the penal colony in Australia. But this didn't happen for Quinn. That, combined with the fact that he never actually laid a hand on the guy he's meant to have killed, tells Quinn that someone is pulling strings to get him killed. So after he barely escapes death, he's determined to figure out who it was and to make them pay. Sure, fine, whatever. I don't care. But Jane does. The first time she catches wind of his intentions, she tells him he should leave it alone. They failed, he's alive, and a duke, no reason to stir up trouble. Honestly, I'm more on Quinn's side with this one. Maybe he doesn't need to get revenge, but I definitely think finding out who wanted him killed and why would be more conducive to a long life. I stop being on Quinn's side when he tells Jane he'll do as she asks and let it go, and then doesn't. Even then, I probably wouldn't have been that bothered by it. It's not all that uncommon in Regency romances, especially Burroughs' Regency romances, for one of the characters to be keeping secrets from their love. If he'd come clean before he did anything stupid, I wouldn't have had a problem. Unfortunately, he does not. Instead, what he does is come home early from work to have sex with her because she always gets sleepy after sex, and he's hoping she'll sleep through the afternoon and never noticed he's slipped out. Then he goes to confront the person he thinks tried to have him killed without any backup or anyone knowing where he's gone. Call me crazy, but I think using sex against someone you supposedly love so that you can do something they asked you not to do and you told them you wouldn't feels like a massive betrayal to me. I don't like it. He gets caught anyway, which is good since he was slightly wrong and may well have been killed if the cavalry hadn't arrived. Jane forgives him, mostly because she loves him and can't stand the idea of what life would be like if she didn't. But I'm not Jane, so I can still be mad. Up till then, however, good book. That's all I have to say about my one and only Duke. If you like this video, I hope you'll watch more in the future. Thanks for watching this one. Bye!